Right. No one on a mic. It looks like only tears. We have a deity on the field, probably. I don't know. It looks like him and Christian are a thing again. I don't know. I can kind of see a team like Tears of Soy would struggle with DDD. I think naturally DDD is just a good pick versus Ryu in general. As me as Big D saying that. Not Big D the Ryu. I think in this situation for Ryu, I think you just like leave DDD alone. If one of the team members wants to like camp on the other side of the stage, just like let him go for his partner. That's usually what I do, and it works really well. Me and Jake, we at Gordo, getting so much out of that one Gordo. Crazy. Okay, Bishley, you gotta not be near the ledge. I mean, you can be near the ledge, you just can't. Oh, shield broken. This is game two. Game two. Alright, good conversion. Oh yeah, blue team was in a tight spot. Down tilt Shoryuken, you can Pikachu on his last stock. DD doing his best to like just hold the stocks. If I was red team, I'd leave him alone. Obviously, it's putting pressure on Landon as he has dropped both of his stocks already. Yeah, honestly, I would just ignore the DDD in this scenario. Like, you're not... The damage you're getting... Like, you're not getting any damage on DDD, and you're just taking a bunch by fighting with the ledge. Just take your advantageous position and fight the Pikachu. I mean, it is Jason's DDD, so obviously it's a bit weaker than the Pikachu in terms of, like, skill. But if you have a 2v1, just go for it. Like, at Genesis, me and Jake, we fought a Japanese, very good Japanese Mii Gunner. Who was teaming with a Sheik. And the Japanese Mii Gunner was really good. He was keeping us out, and was keeping his thing. He was doing his thing. And you know what? Me and Jake were like, you know what? It doesn't matter. We'll let him do his thing, and we'll go after his partner. And Bishley gets forward smash. We'll live that. And Ryu... Both teams. Alright, so now this is looking really hard. Two quick KOs though, and it's looking pretty good. This is definitely doable. There's one. That's probably what. The matchup wise, yeah, I would take DDD over Pikachu. But this is Jason's DDD. Bit more defensive than my DDD. You also have to realize when you're Ryu that like Capnell is gonna avoid everything you have like the flag. You know, if you're willing to like put him in a bad position, make him do whatever. But meanwhile, just like take the your goal should not be to get kills or whatever. Your goal should be to stay alive and make this happen and actively look for opportunities. Like right now, he's trying to force it on Landon, and Landon's just gonna perfect shield that and punish you every time. But in this, and he somehow Ryu is living like through some miracle. Oh, and jab to thunder. Nice combo by blue team. So only tears is up 2-0 in this set. Things that I think red team can work on is just leave Jason alone when he's on the ledge. Like, unless you actually know like everything and like how to punish DD when he's on the ledge, you know, just leave him alone. Leave him alone. You can like maybe stay like half stage and you like have a separation, you keep them apart. But yeah, leave DD alone with the ledge. Okay, so only tears. Only tears. Yeah. All right, get him, Long. Okay, so this is not a bad pick. One thing about Logos' Ryu is that he initiates a lot of his stuff off of like pull hops and the like. And so like Captain L is pretty... And where I'm going with that is that Captain L has seen this, and so he's been playing a very grounded game. And just waiting for those full hops because they're easy to react to. And then shielding whatever attack that Locust comes in with. Yeah, basically leave him alone. Just bait him and do something and do whatever after that. That was good. Me being a DD player myself, it does frustrate me when I see just overall, like, don't know. Oh, and good up smash. That was actually pretty cute. I don't know, that little sliding DD where you just like Pikachu pushed him as he crouched. That was pretty funny. I like that. Oh, good Shoryuken. Captain L dropping the first stock. Everyone play a very dangerous game off stage. Off stage games are like games you don't want to play with a team such as DDD and Pikachu. DDD's recovery, probably one of the best in the game. That's my opinion. Focus clearly going for inhales. Yeah, like, you always have to, you have to respect the back air coming down when you put, when you see DDD in the air. Like, 9 times out of 10, you're gonna see a back air coming down. Okay, so now in this position, unless DDD is on the ledge, I would actually just go, never mind. Honestly, Red Team's doing a pretty good job. Blue Team has to, find some way to adapt. Alright, guess the edge guard on Fox. If I was Blue Team, I would want to go after that Fox as hard as possible. Oh, cute little team combo. Honestly, right now the onus is on Fox to not get hit. Because if Fox gets hit right now, what that means is that as soon as Ryu drops that stock, it's going to be a game of like who's the first one to die. Oh, an excellent team combo. Unfortunately, could not finish that up, but it was actually very good. But yeah, no, Fox has to stay alive. Because the way I see it, right now, Blue Team is no like further away from winning than Red Team. Okay, now they're a little closer to winning. I'm not sure. Yeah, I would. So right now, they're just kind of like looking for opportunities where they can get their KOs. DDT is probably going to look for a lot of back airs. Ryu going to look for some Shoryukens. He's trying to get DDT on the landing, but he can't. Oh, and that'll be it. That'll be it for DDT. Now, Captain L is actually very good at the 2v1. He's hard, he's elusive, he's hard to hit, and he quick attacked right into that up smash. It's almost like he saw it like three steps ago. Now the question is, will Focus stay DDT? I think so far DDT maybe is an improvement in the previous set. Let's just see. I think Red Team is learning to handle DDT and doubles a little bit more. They're understanding you don't want to approach him to the ledge. I didn't see that as much in this game. I didn't see Focus on the ledge that much in this game. They started out strong. They had a lead majority of the set. It was their game. All right, so the pick is Smashville. We got some spot dodge wars in the corner. Oh, Fox off stage. The Thunder. But yeah, one thing I did see though is Logos get hit by a lot of the backers by DDT, like that. And I can totally understand like why. You know, the space that he wants to control is just like taken up so well by DDT's backer. That's why I think that like if I ever face like a Ryu. Oh my god, forward smash killing Bishley, but not his partner, Captain L. A little extra willpower on that one. Alright, hoping for the down tilt sure you can work, but doesn't get it. Good Shoryuken won't kill, DD is heavy. Right, no rage, that won't do it. Alright, so I think what happened there was DD got the inhale. Okay, so that was a good inhale. I think he definitely should not have challenged DD off stage when he was clearly looking for those inhales. Just doing a lot of things that like you should not be doing. Oh, is that the TSM Gecko? Yeah. Bishley's taking a beating this game. It's tough. And you can also tell that Logos is getting a little antsy, just trying to force into the Pikachu. Oh, excellent spike, but Pikachu is Pikachu. Alright. Yeah, Bishley needs to take it. This is very, very tough. This is tough. But it's doable, but the Ryu needs to stay alive. Honestly, don't even worry about DDT. That's my thoughts. Of course, I say this as a not as Big D the Ryu player, but as Big D the Devil's God. Alright. Yeah, you know, he needs to tech this and no tech. Okay, so yeah, Locust finds himself in a difficult predicament. He needs to avoid getting killed, he needs to avoid getting grabbed, and there it is. And there it is. Alright, and only Tears takes a 3-1. Alright, now where's Jake?